प्रभु तू ही है, यीशु तू ही है, प्रभु तू ही है, यीशु तू ही है, मेरे जीवन का सहारा यीशु तू ही है, प्रभु तू ही है, यीशु तू ही है, मेरे जीवन की ज्योति यीशु तू ही है, प्रभु तू ही है, यीशु तू ही है, जीवन रोटी तू ही, सत्य तू ही है, प्रभु तू ही है, यीशु तू ही है, हालेलुया, आमेन, हालेलुया, हालेलुया, आमेन, हालेलुया।
प्रेज द लॉर्ड एवरीवन। लास्ट टाइम वी हैड रीड जेनेसिस 41, टुडे विल स्टार्ट विद जेनेसिस 42। When Jacob learned that there was grain in Egypt, he said to his sons, "Why do we just keep looking at each other?" He continued, "I have heard that there is grain in Egypt. Go down there and buy some for us so that we may live and not die." Then 10 of Joseph's brothers went down to buy grain from Egypt, but Jacob did not send Benjamin, Joseph's brother, with the others because he afraid that harm might come to him. So Israel's sons were among those who went to buy grain, for there was famine in the land of Canaan also. Now Joseph was the governor of the land, the person who sold grain to all its people. So when Joseph's brothers arrived, they bowed down to him with their faces to the ground. As soon as Joseph saw his brothers, he recognized, but he pretended that be a stranger and spoke harshly to them. "Where do you come from?" he asked. "From the land of Canaan," they replied, "to buy food." Although Joseph recognized his brother, they did not recognize him. Then he remembered his dreams about them and said to them, "You are spies. You have come to see where our land is unprotected." "Now, my lord," they answered, "your servants have come to buy food. We are all the sons of men. Your servants are honest men, not spies." "No," he said to him, "you have come to see where our land is unprotected." But they replied, "Your servants were 12 brothers, the sons of one man who lives in the land of Canaan. The youngest is now with our father and one is no more." Joseph said to him, "It is just as I told you, you are spies, and this is how you will be tested. As surely as Pharaoh lives, you will not leave this place unless your youngest brother come here. Send one of your number to get your brother. The rest of you will be kept in the prison so that your words may be tested to see if you are telling the truth. If you are not, then as surely as Pharaoh lives, you are spies." And he put them all in the custody for 3 days. When the third day, Joseph said to them, "Do this and you will live, for I fear God. If you are honest men, let one of your brothers stay here in the prison while the rest of you go and take grain back for your starving household. But you must bring your youngest brother to me so that your words may be verified and that you may not die." This they proceed to do. They said to one another, "Surely we are being punished because of our brother. We saw how distressed he was when he pleaded with us for his life, but we would not listen. That's why with distress has come on us." Reuben replied, "Did not tell you not to sin against the boy, but you would not listen. Now we must give an accounting for his soul." But they did not realize that Joseph could understand them, since he was using an interpreter. He turned away from them and began to weep, but then came back and spoke to them. He had Simeon taken from them and bound before their eyes. Joseph gave orders to fill their bags with grain, to put each man's silver bag in his sack, and to give them provisions for the journey after this was done for them. They loaded their grain on their donkeys and left at the place where they spotted for the night. One of them opened his sack to get feed for his donkey, and he saw his silver in the mouth of his sack. "My silver has been returned," he said to his brothers. "Here it is in my sack." Their hearts sank, and they turned to each other trembling and said, "What is this that God has done to us?" When they came to their father Jacob in the land of Canaan, they told him that all had happened to them. Amen. God bless you all.